I know that in this company we have so much competence and so much good people who really want to do things differently. Now after I have started to talk about that it's all about customers and profits, I know that already now it has inspired people to, okay, let's now really think commercial. Let's try to do what's best for the company in terms of making more money and giving customers what they want. And people seem to be really inspired of it. However, we do have not yet released all the forces of the good people to do that. And for us to be able to make the people start to move in different corners of the company, we need something to unite around. And that is probably our biggest challenge of all in this company, to release the powerful forces of all the people to make our vision, however we put it at the end, come true. It's extremely stimulating to see that as we go, it will narrow down and narrow down and narrow down our opinions about what the vision really should be. And at the end of the day, it will narrow down to such an extent that we will be able to unite and formulate a vision together. And I've seen that before, how that works. At first time you think there are so many different views about this, and it may seem when you hear people talk about what they think the vision should be, that how can we unite around something? It is so much, could be this and that. But after a while, we will be amazed by how it will narrow down, and we will think, this is it. And that feeling, when you really see it converging because of the input of all the people and that they do agree about it, that's what creates the power in it. The whole point in this vision and values process is to narrow down our thinking to what is really very most important. The vision should be clear-cut and specific, energizing to all of us. It should make us love to go to work. It should make us feel proud about the company, because it is focused, it is that mountain we want to climb, but it's also specific in the sense that that is what we're going to do, not something very general. Then it's not inspiring. And it's all about interaction between different people in the company, between management, within management groups, within management and their employees, between employees across the company. In fact, we want to have as much interaction between people as we ever can get, especially now in this process. Because it is our joint vision that we're going to develop. We are not going to let it become too general and too a non-inspiring statement. We have made up our mind about that. And that's why it's so difficult. It's one of the most difficult things you can do. And that's why we need to have all the involvement, and that's why we need to take time to do it. Could have been very easy for the executive management of the company to sit down in a room and think about it for a couple of hours and write down a slogan. That's not the point. We might have a slogan at the end that will summarize what we have done, but it is the content of what we have developed together and the process to get there, which is the key. It's all about alignment, and that's all about visionary leadership. To have a leadership in place which is guided by a vision. A vision that has been agreed between the people because it's so good and strong that we like it all. We're inspired by it in our daily life. It helps us to make decisions. It helps us to avoid detailed management. Instead, we are guided by our vision and our roadmaps that we create. And in that way, people can act on their own. That's visionary leadership. And the role for leaders is to coach people, to help people to do their work in that context. And the vision is what helps us all as the guiding star for all of that. I'm surprised by the openness. People really bring forward what they think are the shortcomings of their own organization. What we are not doing so well in Sweden, what we are not doing so well in Finland. We will see what is coming forward in the other parts of the company. We haven't had those meetings yet. And they are really saying that this is something that we've had a problem with for years. I'm not going to reveal here exactly what it is, because I think we should process that more. But people are really willing to talk about that. And that is so important, because that is necessary to understand when we are going to decide where we're going to put our spotlight on the values in the future. In other words, the good parts that we want to emphasize and the bad parts that we want to re-emphasize. So when people understand where they're coming from and are open about it, that's very important. It's a wonderful place to be. It's one of the best industries you can be in. It's one of the most environmental friendly industries in the world. It's even improving environment because we travel less. And we should not underestimate the enormous importance that telecom has to any country, whether it's a well-developed country like Sweden or Finland or Norway, and whether it's a country that has not come as far yet, like the Baltic countries. In any country, telecommunication services is an indispensable element of the society. Turn it off, it comes to chaos. Use it more, in a more advanced way. You can even build new things in society. You can create things that you couldn't create otherwise. And there's no end to what we can achieve in the society through telecommunications. It's just our imagination that sets the limits. And today, technology is not a limitation. I think in many big companies, and it has happened also in this company, people have seen many initiatives before. They have waited to see whether the new initiative would actually be something that disappears after a while. Or as they say, if I just bow down for a while, the wind will blow over my head and I can race in the wind again and everything's back to normal. Nothing has happened. They have seen that before. This is not going to happen this time. We are going to make a lasting impact, and we are very determined to make sure that we are going to create something that we're going to live. That's the difference. The values that we will agree on, we are going to live, we are going to behave, we're going to walk on that floor that we have agreed and not another one. And the vision we will set up for ourselves is a vision we are going to strive for, and we are going to make sure that that happens by setting up interim or midterm targets that take us in that direction of the vision if we achieve them, and then put strategies in place that make sure that we do get there. So it is nothing else than strong leadership to really go in the direction we have agreed. And if we are not going in that direction, we're going to guide the company accordingly, away from the wrong direction or away from the wrong values to really stand on the floor in the right way. Already now I see this convergence going on, that people tend to agree slowly in the same direction. We're not quite sure which one exactly, but it is happening. And it will be even more interesting after this summer when we've had the first full round of this project.